Let's play some more Dungeon Hack. I'm Duke of the Bum. When we last left off, we were still exploring level 1 of the dungeon. Let's load up our old save here. I am increasing the CPU cycles of DOSBox, which is what I'm using to play this game, which makes it run faster than it normally does. For example, on the original hardware, the map takes several seconds to come up, whereas with the CPU cycle increase of DOSBox, the map comes up almost instantaneously, and there are a few other little gameplay tweaks. So, I'm just doing that to make things a little easier, a little faster. Because, you know, this is a very old game. Back then, people weren't as impatient as they are now. See what this wand does. Okay. I think it hit him, but it didn't seem to really do anything. And now I used all the charges. That's weird. Raise Dead Spell would destroy a specter. I think I'll be getting one of those eventually. Man, that was the crappiest wand I ever found. It hit people for like one. And it only had like four charges. I was probably just beating them with a wand. It wasn't even casting a spell. I was just beating them over the head with it. So this looks like it's probably going to be my longest LP to date, my longest solo LP. I recorded a practice run of the first level or so, and it took me 4 videos just to make it to the next level. Because, I mean, these dungeons are pretty huge. And I did something stupid and let myself get surrounded. What I did just now was cast Turn Undead, which as you can see causes a zombie to flee from me, making it much easier for me to fight him without getting hit. But since I hit him, the effects wore off. Scroll of Poison and a Clear Potion. Interesting. Let's see what that potion does. I sense the presence of monsters. Holy cow, that is a lot of monsters. That is a lot of red dots. By the way, to anyone watching this on YouTube, I encourage you to watch it on Stage 6 instead. It's a special hosting service for DivX files. It requires a plugin in order to view the video, but I think that it comes through a lot more clearly than it does on YouTube, and it just looks better overall. Okay, looks like the next way I need to go is all the way over next to the exit. So, let's take my, never mind. I was thinking of a previous, practice run. I don't have that item anymore. A lot of monsters. In fact, let's use our amulet. Why not? I made short work of them. I'm probably already out of charges though. But God, so many monsters. I said in a previous video that my favorite, that this was one of my favorite roguelike games. It's not actually my favorite, though. My favorite is NetHack. Because it's just so... There's just so much more to it. I mean, it amazes me what they're able to do randomly with that game. I mean, they do a pretty good job of making random dungeons here. But, I mean, there aren't any shops. There's no treasure rooms. Those are always fun. You go into a room filled with monsters, and once you kill them all, there's a ton of treasure for you to get. Now, treasure in this game is always pretty sparse. I don't have the key for that lock. I think I'm on the right track, yeah. I guess I might as well wear this key. I mean, I already know it's not cursed. Can't be any harm in it. Did I say key or ring? I don't know. I just have keys on the brain. This game makes you look at everything as if it might possibly be a key. It's like, a scroll. Cleric scrolls are only good for one use. You use it and it uses up the spell and it's gone. With magic user scrolls, you can actually use them to add the spell to your spellbook, so you can memorize it later. Which is pretty neat. Oh, excuse me. Grappling hook. That'll be useful to us if we fall in any pits. Yep, elementals can only be hit by magic weapons. But that's okay. Since I'm a cleric, if I don't have a magic weapon handy, I can always just make one. I've played tabletop D&D a few times. Years and years ago, way before 3rd edition came out. I don't remember clerics having any spells that made them make magical weapons out of thin air. Well, let's see. Now where do I go? Let's see. Can't go that way. It's blocked off. I need to go that way, it looks like. Unless there's a secret... an illusionary wall somewhere. But I'll try the door first. Truth be told, I should probably be more diligent about looking for illusionary walls. Now, there's so many more monsters on this difficulty level than there are on easy. It's insane. Come on. Better heal myself a little bit. I almost always play a cleric when I play this game, just because the spells are so useful. I mean, it's just insanely useful to be able to heal yourself, you know, pretty much whenever you want. Now, in the other game that uses this engine, Eye of the Beholder, which I'd also like to LP someday, instead of just being one guy, you have a whole party. It's more like an actual game of D&D. So you can have a healer and a magic user and a couple fighters. I think you have 4 people in your party in that game. Or was it 6? I don't know, it's been so long. Did I talk about this? The gold coin? Well, scattered around the dungeon there are these shrines with a slot that you can put a coin in. And if you put in a silver coin, then it heals you a little bit. If you put in a gold coin, then it heals you a lot. Oh, my detect magic spell expired. But that's okay. Yeah, the shrines are pretty useful if you're playing any character besides the cleric. Because, you know, it's the only way you can really heal yourself, except for resting for a really long time. Which isn't good because it uses a lot of food. And, you don't want to run out of food. Alright, well, we're just about out of time for this video, so I'll go ahead and save it here. And I'll see you next time on more Let's Play Dungeon Hack. I'm Duke of the Bomb. See you guys later.